So just all kind of interruptions and technical difficulties. Be patient with me. I will here we go, Matthew, chapter 3, verse 4. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them, saying, "Where is the place that is written of by the prophets, in which Christ?" Okay, that's all right. That tells me something up there. We'll just continue with Matthew chapter 3 as originally planned. Sorry about that. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism, he said unto them, "O generation of vipers, who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Why is it that ye receive not the preachings of him whom God hath sent? If ye receive not this in your hearts, ye receive not me. And if ye receive not me, ye receive not him of whom I am sent to bear record. And for your sins, ye have no cloak. Repent, therefore, and bring forth fruit meet for repentance. And think not to say among within yourselves, 'We are the children of Abraham, and we only have power to bring seed unto our father Abraham.' But I say unto you that God is able of these stones to raise up children of Abraham. And now also the wax is laid unto the root of the tree. Therefore, every tree which bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. I indeed baptize you with water upon your repentance. And when he of whom I bear record cometh, who is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear, for whose place I am not able to fill. And I said, 'I indeed baptize you before he cometh, that when he cometh, he may baptize you with the fire of the Holy Ghost in fire. And it is he of whom I shall bear record, whose fan shall be in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor and gather his wheat into the garner, but in the faithless, in his own time, will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. Then came John preaching and baptizing in the river of Jordan, bearing record that he who was coming after him and power to baptize, and had power to baptize with the Holy Ghost and fire. Then cometh Jesus from Galilee to Jordan unto John to be baptized. But John forbade him, saying, I have need to be baptized of thee, and comest thou to me? And Jesus answering said unto him, Suffer me to be baptized of thee. For thus it becometh us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he suffered him. And John went down into the water and baptized him. And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water. And John saw, and lo, the heavens were open unto him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting upon Jesus. And lo, he heard a voice from heaven saying, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear ye him. This is indeed one of the biggest moments, one of the biggest chapters in Christian history. Okay? One of the biggest chapters. And you might say, but Jimmy, why? Think about it. Jesus was holy. He really didn't need to be baptized. Yet, to show the path back home to Heavenly Father, he made the first step to be baptized. Baptized by his own cousin, John the Baptist, who had the Aaronic priesthood. The Melchizedek priesthood had not been restored yet. You think about it. Jesus come out of Galilee, out of obscurity, working for Mary and Joseph. Being called into a ministry, right? Now I want you to think about this. It sounds insane, I know. But the fact of the matter is this. God created this role for us. Jesus was the one being called to live the whole law. But yet these scribes and Pharisees, they wanted to be baptized. And they said, but we live the whole law. when we choose to enter the covenant baptism, we make a pledge. We make a covenant to keep the commandments of the Lord. And that's a covenant that we are required to keep, regardless. And I can hear some of you now. Kenny, sometimes I feel like you're just being too harsh. Am I really? I can hope to be there to strengthen you guys. Because I'll tell you something. Baptism is the gateway ordinance. It puts us on the straight and narrow path. And who are we to not do it? Christ is holy. But you know what? He participated in it to fulfill all righteousness. And I know it feels weird probably for him to be baptized by a cousin who he probably hadn't seen in years, if ever. And I can hear some of you right now. But Jimmy, the fact of the matter is this. We are called to live God's law. No questions. We are called to live His commandments. Right? But Jimmy, you're being tough. Why are you being that way? It's because I know what the Lord has called me to do, be, and have. The thing is, we have to know who we place our trust in. Do we keep the Lord's commandments? Do our best to live it? None of us are perfect. But can we do our best? Can we make a pledge to live a righteous life? It's not just enough to have a testimony anymore. It's, do you live it? I hope with that, I apologize for all the problems and all the interruptions. With that, I hope you enjoy listening to Christian Pattern. If you like to hear, please subscribe and become a part of the Christian Pattern family. Until next time, remember who you are, read your scriptures, and please, please, please preach the gospel. God bless you and have a blessed day.